Dimensioning with inspect and other options. Inspection dimensions allow you to effectively communicate how frequently manufactured parts should be checked to ensure that the dimension value and the tolerances of the parts are within the specified limits or the range. Jog lines are used to represent a dimension value that does not display the actual measurement in a linear dimension, and also user defined dimension text alignment can also be done. So in this session, we shall discuss all these things into details with practical examples. We can show you that here we have put the inspect option here. Here we are having one jog, and here this respective dimension text has been made oblique. So let us go for one demonstration where all these aspects will be discussed and also will be shown you in the practical demonstration. So here is the demonstration for you. So here we will be using multiple different options of dimensions. We are drawing one circle here at first. So I want to mark the center point of the circle. So here, from here, you can easily mark the center. So option is center mark. So select this one, then center point will be marked accordingly. I'm drawing one linear dimension here. There's a linear dimension I have drawn. Now I want to inspect this one. So I'm selecting this and going for the inspect. So this is option that is the inspect dimension. So I can select this round, corner or angular or none. I'm just selecting this one for an example, angular. You can select your label here. So this is my, say, dim label. I'm giving this name as dim label 1. And here you can have this inspection rate. You can make it 80% or say 100%, whatever you require. And accordingly, you are going to reflect the same. So select dimension, selecting this one and pressing enter, and then OK. So accordingly, the inspect options will be coming, will be reflected on the dimension. Now we are going for the jog. So here we are having this option that is the jog. So dimension jog line. So dim jog line can also be issued here. So I'm just clicking here and applying on here. At this point, I'm going to apply. So that is our jog. Next one, we are going to do some dim edit. Going for a new. I want to change this respective label. So I'm making this one, say 10.42. Pressing enter and clicking outside. So 10.42 will be coming here according to the requirement. So now let me go for another example. So I'm selecting this linear. I want to make this dimension to 10.42. So dim edit. New. So what was the value previously it was having? I'm just erasing. So I'm making this one as 10.42 and pressing enter. And then I'm selecting this object and pressing enter. So 10.42. So the new dimension text has got inserted. So now I'm selecting this one, going for here. I can make it left aligned, center aligned. And similarly, I can also go for the right alignment. Now we can also put this text oblique in nature. So now we are going for that option, text angle, selecting this, selecting the respective angle here. The text will be aligned accordingly. Now here, this particular text can also be moved along with the dimension line. So now we can find that the text can be moved along the dimension line accordingly. In this way, you can do different types of manipulations, adjustments, and different types of updations on our dimensions. Thanks for watching this.